Hello people, welcome to this video. Let's see quickly all the most important features inside CyberLink PowerDirector 15 in order to start straight. We are also offering, for the first time, a super giveaway of 3 free copies of this amazing software. Watch this video to know how to win your free copy. PowerDirector is one of the best and easiest video editing software available on the market. It is used to catch videos, edit your own media, and extract professional rendered videos and disk menus. When you open it, a dialog box opens, showing you several main features inside this software. On top, choose the correct aspect ratio for your video project, including the new 9:16 used to create and render videos by using the vertical orientation of smartphones. Another new feature is the 360-degree editor, used to realize complete spherical videos. Check out our related video to discover more about it. The full feature editor is the main and most complete interface of PowerDirector, where you can create your customized video by manually placing clips, effects, and transitions. The other workspaces you see are used to create professional projects in no time by using ready-made templates. For example, the Easy Editor creates a video by putting videos and photos automatically following a chosen template. You can also use the Theme Designer or the Express Project to create videos manually by following a ready template. To create great slideshows with your photos, you can use the Slideshow Creator. Let's see in this video how to create your own videos with the full feature editor. Here you have the timeline below composed by several rows called tracks. This is the region you will work inside your project and create your custom video. We are now giving away 3 copies of this new software for free. To win your own copy, leave a comment here below and tell us why PowerDirector would be great and helpful for your future videos. You will receive the free copy within the middle of November 2016. Before starting with your project, you have to import all the media files you will create your project with. The Media Room in the top left corner collects several files available, such as media, old projects, backgrounds, and ready templates. You can import any by clicking and dragging them on the timeline. You can also import external files from your computer by dragging them on the timeline. Whereas if you need to capture media files, you can use the Capture tab to record from webcams, microphones, or your own screen by using CyberLink Screen Recorder. All files imported on the timeline are represented through blocks called clips. You can select a clip by clicking on it. Photos, videos, and audio files are in blue color with their own thumbnails and sound waveforms that you can check better by enlarging the track that contains them. Other special clips, such as particles, effects, and text, are always in green color. Use the preview on the right and its player below to check what your project looks like. This has 2 different modes. When you are in clip mode, you will use the preview to edit the clip appearance by moving, scaling, and rotating it. When you are in movie mode, you will play all the content inside your timeline. In particular, the preview always shows what is under the red playhead, so by moving the playhead, you can check your project frame by frame. Click on the timeline to fix the playhead to check a particular frame. If you click and drag the playhead, you will check your project carefully forwards or backwards. Also, below the preview, you can take direct snapshots and adjust preview quality settings to use. Double-click inside the preview to check it in full screen mode. use the Escape key to exit. Let's see how to work with your clips inside the timeline. If you click and hold on the timeline, you zoom in and out around the playhead. To move any clip in time, just click and drag it through the same track or in another track. If you move a video clip, both video frames and audio will be moved together. To make these independent, right-click on the clip and go to Link, Unlink, Video, and Audio. To select multiple clips together, click and drag on your timeline to create a selection area. All clips within it will be selected. The timeline is composed of different kinds of tracks. Video tracks, recognized by a frame icon on the left, contains anything visible, such as video frames, text, and pictures. Audio tracks with a loudspeaker icon, containing anything regarding to sound, music, and speech. And the effect tracks, used to place effects that are applied on all the clips placed on the upper tracks. More below. You have other tracks dedicated to text, speech, and music. The track's order is very important since it sets the order at which clips are shown on your project. All clips that are placed on a downer video track are always shown above all clips on the upper video track. On the left, there are several options to manage your tracks. Use the third icon right above to add a new pair of video and audio tracks. Use the check mark to enable, disable a track in order to show or completely hide its content. The next icon is used to lock the track in order not to change anything inside the track and its content. It is also very important to regulate the duration of each clip. You can do so in two ways. If you select the clip and click and drag from one of its edges, you will stretch or shorten its duration in time. You won't have problems with pictures and text, but for other clips that have a fixed duration, such as audio and video clips, you can't stretch over their original duration. If you do so, you won't change the playback speed of the clip, you will just edit the clip content. Another way is the trimming. If you click and drag from the clip edges while holding Control down, you will always shorten or stretch the clip, but not acting on the clip content, but on its playback speed only. So, if you shorten the clip, this will be simply played faster, otherwise it will be played slower. An eye icon appears on a corner indicating the video speed effect has been applied. Remember, if you make any mistake, you can undo your latest actions by using Control and Z or using the Undo button at the very top. Also, right-click on a clip to cut, copy, paste, or delete it. To split a clip in two instead, just fix the red playhead, right-click, and go to Split. Fast corrections can be made on both audio and video clips. For example, you can correct the volume of any audio or video clip by using the envelope line on the sound waveform. You can pull up one of its two endpoints to increase or decrease the volume in time, as you can see from the waveform itself, or you can click on the envelope line to add your own points and customize the volume envelope. Also, video and picture clips have a green envelope line, indicating their level of opacity. If you pull it down, the clip will become more transparent. Check out our video guide to know how to professionally edit your own clips. Another useful tool is the crop tool used to remove unwanted parts from a picture or simply adapt it to the project aspect ratio. Each of the visible clips can be easily edited through the clip mode of the preview. Directly on the preview, click and drag to move the clip with respect to the focus of your project. Use the white nodes to scale the clip and the blue nodes to skew and distort it. You can also rotate the clip by hovering the blue circle on the center and clicking and dragging from it. PowerDirector also has lots of powerful transitions and effects, all listed in the Effect room and in the Transition room. To apply any effect, just click and drag one on your clip. To apply a transition, just click and drag it on one of the edges of a clip. This applies a nice effect while your clip appears and when it disappears. You can also apply transitions between two clips. Just approach two clips close enough and choose crossfade to apply a standard fade transition between them. Then, just drop the transition you prefer from the transition room. To learn more about effects and transitions, check out our dedicated video in this guide. Let's see how to save and export your project. To save all your work inside your timeline, such as clips and effects applied, go to File and then to Save Project As. Your project will be saved in a PDF file format used to open your project later to edit it. If you want to extract the final video from your project in order to watch it or upload it online, you have to render it first. Just go to the Produce workspace on top and choose between several options PowerDirector offers. Choose Standard 2D to render your video inside your computer, choosing the file format you prefer and its aspect ratio. More on the right. Check out the estimated file size and fix the export folder to save the video into. Use 3D to render any 3D video. Choose device to render your video with the correct file format for several devices such as smartphones and consoles. Go to the Online tab to render and directly upload your video to social websites such as Facebook, YouTube, Dailymotion, and Vimeo, choosing the video quality. More below. When you are ready, click on the Start button to start rendering. The video will be rendered from the beginning of your timeline, even if vacant, till the end of the last clip. Check out our video to know how to apply the best render settings to your video to upload in YouTube with an Ultra HD quality. Thanks for watching this video. Check out our complete guide to learn more about CyberLink PowerDirector 15. And don't forget to leave a comment below to win a free copy of this software.